In this video, I'm going to show you my top three choices for Python apps to use on an Android device. In a previous video, which I've linked below, I showed you something similar on iOS devices. Now, let me know if you agree with my choices. Perhaps there are other applications that you prefer using. Please put that in the comments below. Let me know if you agree with my three choices for Python apps to use on an Android device. My first choice is PyDroid 3. What's nice about this application is it has an interpreter as well as a terminal. So on the interpreter, I could type print hello world. So there you go, basic output of print hello world on the interpreter. This application has both a free and paid version. You don't have access to premium libraries in the free version. There's no code prediction, there's no code analysis, and the ads are removed. So you can pay £10 in this example for lifetime access. I prefer that, or you can do a monthly subscription. I think monthly subscriptions are a really bad idea. You can use the application for free and do quite a lot with the application. As an example, if I go to quick install, you can see a whole bunch of libraries are installed. One of the libraries that's fantastic is the Jupyter library. Now, I've actually installed that already. But if you click install, you can see I've reinstalled it. So under quick install, you can see there are a whole bunch of libraries here. Pandas is available as an example, and some other fantastic libraries. But the great thing with Jupyter is if I go to terminal and I now type a Jupyter notebook, I get access to Jupyter notebooks. This is fantastic because I have a IDE that I can use. I can also run commands and see the output. Here's an example. I could go new Python 3, and there you go. I'm running Jupyter notebooks. And as an example, I could do my typical print hello world. And notice it's color-coded. It's fantastic. If I run the code, there's the output. I've got a wonderful IDE here that I can access. And then I can see the output of my code directly. So I could do something like that and run the code. And as you can see there, it's printed hello world. A has been set to 1, so A is a variable that I've set to 1, and I've printed the value of A, which is 1. I could save that. So save as, let's say, test. And then I could open other notebooks that I've created. So here's one called Untitled, bad name. But notice I've got a whole bunch of cells here. So I could do my typical hello world. Notice how the number's incrementing from 1 to 2 to 3 here every time I run the code. And I mean, I could type something else here like print. And I'll just say 2, just to show you that it changes. And there you go. So hello world, print 2. And I could run that again. So pressing that multiple times, you can see it's incrementing. But I've also got other code here. So in the second cell, what I've got here is A equals 1. So I've set the variable A equal to 1. This is a while loop. So while true, print hello world. If A equals 3, then break the loop. Otherwise, set A to A plus 1. So notice what it's done here is it's printed hello world 3 times. So I could jump from one piece of code to the other. So back to my first piece of code, I could set A equal to 1 like that. And then I could simply print A like that. So notice output 18 equals 1, out 19, out 20 equals 1. Now I could do a proper print here. So rather than showing it that way, so print A and run the code and notice hello world 2, 1. And then jump to this piece of code and then run my script. And what I'll do is I'll just change that to let's say 4. And notice it's printed hello world 4 times. And I could literally, let's say, make it 10. So just change the values of the code and then rerun the code. And here I've got a for loop. So for I in range 10, print I. So run that again. And notice it's printing 0 to 9. So I could change that to, let's say, 20 as an example and run the code. And there you go. I've got 0 to 19 printed. Run that again. 0 to 19, and I could change that to some other value, let's say 8, and run the code. And notice 0 to 7 has been printed. So that's called a for loop. So for I in the range 8, so 0 to 7, print I. So what is I equal to? It equals 0, 1, 2, all the way up to 7. Fantastic that you can use Jupyter Notebooks directly within PyDroid. You could obviously just use the interpreter directly here. You can get more IDEs if you like. So they've got PyDroid IDE for Python 3. You could get it for Python 2. Really bad idea to do that today, but you could do it for Java as well. You could use pip once again to install various libraries. In the free version, you get access to a whole bunch of libraries. I think the brilliant one here is the fact that you get Jupyter. So you can do a whole bunch of stuff with Jupyter Notebooks. So in summary, the free version is limited. Premium gives you access to more versions. You can see a comparison once again between premium and free here. It has an interpreter, it has a terminal, it also has an editor. But what I really like about it is that you can use Jupyter Notebooks directly within this application. So you can install Jupyter Notebooks and then simply use the command Jupyter Notebook to run your code. So I think this is a fantastic application. What do you think? Put in the comments below. Did I miss any other cool features in this application? Any other restrictions in this application? Put that in the comments below. My second application is QPython 3L, another great application. I prefer PyDroid, but this has some cool options. As an example, if I go to programs, so speak, run, and let's say, hello world, and press OK.
Hello world.
So as you can see, there's some code here that you can have a look at, like Bluetooth chat. There's a bunch of code that you could copy, as an example, into your scripts. It has got a console. So once again, print hello world. So there's our code. It's got an editor. So as an example, there's the code that we were looking at previously. But I could create a new blank file. And it has got line numbers. I could also create a script if I prefer. So you've got an editor, you've got scripts that you can use. So this is great because it has an editor where you can edit your code, you can install pip packages, have some great packages pre-installed that give you access to your phone. So once again, under programs, a whole bunch of options here. So as an example, hello world, very basic. It says hello Android there. So if I go to hello world, open, you can see the code there, hello Android, print hello world. If I run that, you can see it says hello world and hello Android. It's easy to use, but is really limited to Python. There's no ads and it's free, so that's fantastic. It gives you the interactive shell as well. Please note that some of the sample programs in my experience don't work. You'll have to test it yourself and see how it goes. So if you just want a simple application, this is great, but I personally prefer PyDroid 3. What's your opinion of PyDroid 3 versus QPython 3L? Do you prefer one over the other? Let me know in the comments below once again. Okay, one that I've previously demonstrated in a video below where I showed you how to use Linux and Python on your phone is Termux. Termux can be installed from the Play Store, just like the other applications, but it's recommended that you don't do that. You need to go to the GitHub link to install it. Otherwise, you can have issues. There's also problems using Termux on Android 12. There is a fix to this, which is shown here, or I'll put the link below as well. You can fix it in later releases of Android 12. This is open source, which is great, and it's free. The wonderful thing about Termux is that it's running Linux. Now, just before I go any further, I'm using Android 12 in this example, and I haven't done that fix. So it seems to be working okay on my phone. Sometimes the processes do get killed, so it's something to be aware of if you have issues. The great thing here is it's really flexible. It's basically Linux here. So you can install Python here and run Python directly on the phone. So in this example, I've got Python 3.10 running. This is more than Python. This allows you to run other applications, Linux applications directly on your phone. So you could, as an example, install Nano. You could install Vim. You can install a whole bunch of applications directly on here, SSH, etc. You can also install IPython. So IPython is fantastic. It gives you more than the basic Python installation. So notice what it's done there. And I can autocomplete that. So print hello, it remembered what I typed previously. I can use the up key here and then say hello world. It's giving me the colors to tell me what I'm doing. And there you go, it gives the output. So this I would say is different to the other applications. This is free. It's open source. I'll put the commands below showing you how to install Python and IPython. But basically what you should do is you should update your packages. So pkg update as an example. And then you use the command pkg install Python to install Python. That's already installed. And then you use the command pip install IPython to get IPython installed. So I like Termux because it's free, it's Linux, it's open source. And because it's Linux, you can basically do almost anything that you would do with Linux. Now, there are some restrictions because of Android. So you can't install Scapy as an example and get access to all the Scapy functionality. But you can do some basic stuff with Scapy. You can install SSH. You can install a whole bunch of Python libraries. You're not restricted here, except to what the operating system allows you to do. So those are my top three applications. If you're new, perhaps start with PyDroid 3 and QPython 3L. If you really want the power of Linux and the power of Python, then have a look at Termux, but be aware of some of the issues with Termux. The other two applications do restrict you in some ways. There's certain things that you can and cannot do, but Termux gives you a whole bunch of power. The problem with Termux is you could have issues sometimes with Android 12, and it's not as easy to use as the other applications, but gives you a lot of power if you just want access to a terminal. Okay, so what do you think? Do you agree with my top three choices? Are there other applications that you prefer using on an Android phone? What do you think? Did I cover the sort of advantages and disadvantages of the three applications? Anything that I've missed, please put in the comments below so that others can also learn from you. Now, I'm David Bomble, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like it. Please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and clicking on the bell to get notifications. I want to wish you all the very best.